EA Sports. It's in the game.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome your Super Bowl champion, Green Bay Packers. All right, Lambo, it's time for the offensive starters of your Green Bay Packers. At wide receiver from Western Michigan, number 85, Greg James. And at quarterback from California, number 12,
to historic Lambeau Field in Green Bay, Wisconsin, where we've been blessed with wonderfully mild weather. Glad to have you with us for this head-to-head between the Packers and the Buccaneers. The Buccaneers.
Playing on the road, always a difficult place to win. What does the traveling team have to do?
Well, Gus, there's no question that not only do you have to overcome a terrific football team, but you have to overcome one of the toughest environments in the National Football League. So emotionally, you almost have to find your own energy on the field. The bench has to be alive. You have to be cheering for each other. You just have to create that raw emotion to overcome what the crowd is giving you on the other side.
All right, Chris, and with that in mind, time to get this one going. We are ready.
The NFL on EA Sports right now.
So now the quarterback comes onto the field, and in conversations with him earlier in the week, he mentioned that he really wanted to get going early and get into a rhythm. Let's see if he can do just that.
They'll start at the 20. First down and 10. With the misdirection.
And let's spotlight the offensive key players. Running back Peyton Hillis out of Arkansas has become a sensation, grinding out those tough yards between the tackles.
And it doesn't always have to be pretty to be effective, and Peyton Hillis is one of the hardest working running backs in the league. You know, not only is he so tough to bring down, but he has acceleration into the hole, and that is really underrated.
And Chris, he is definitely primed to be a performer to watch in this one. Defensively, this is a unit that is all about balance. From the guys up front to the guys in the secondary, it's a unit that is just solid. And it's led by free safety Nick Collins out of Bethune-Cookman College, who has become a perennial Pro Bowler.
You know, safeties are a lot of times the generals of the secondary, and Nick Collins is one of the best. He has great instincts for anticipating where a play is going and continually shows terrific closing speed.
Looks like they're going for it here on fourth down. Passes it short. Nick Barnett was there for the stop.
And defensively, they have to be kicking themselves right now, giving up that first down. It looked like they had a stop, but here they face a fresh set of downs.
First down, 10 to go. And that's the end of the first quarter. No score after one. Brady hands it off. 5-yard pickup. Second down and 5 to go. Ball on their own 38. Hand off to the right side. The stop was made by Clay Matthews.
Nothing makes a defensive coordinator cringe more than seeing that kind of run, because then it sets up the play action and there's almost no way to stop an offensive. Can't stop the run, and you have to deal with play action.
And we'll have a first down and 10. Ball on their own 46. And the tackle was made by Charles Woodson. 3 yards there. 3 yard gain on the play. From their own 49-yard line. And they'll run him again. Nick Collins was there to bring him down.
And they're going to have to really start hustling back to the line of scrimmage now because he didn't get out of bounds. Now your offense has to get in that hurry-up mode.
It's first and 10. Give to the tailback. Gets out to around the 35. Nick Collins was there for the stop. Short yardage situation here, second and a yard. He doesn't get back to the line.
And when your defensive line can handle their guys up front and not allow the offensive lineman to get down on the linebackers, it really gives those linebackers a chance to look great.
Hillis takes it left. He just gave his team a huge lift with that carry.
That's just getting it done. You can credit the offensive line all you want, but when you get a back in that third down situation that's able to break off a big one like that, what a lift it gives your football team.
The Buccaneers put up three for the first points of the game. Number five is ready to kick this one off. Williams stands back to field the kick. The stop was made by number 21. Now we have a first down and 10 to go. Grant on the right side. Brian Urlacher was there to bring him down. And we've come to halftime here. The score at the halfway mark is the Buccaneers, 3. The Packers, nothing. It looks like we're just about ready for the second half kickoff. He gets it back out to the 20-yard line. Barwin was there for the stop. They'll go to work at the 20-yard line. First down and 10. He's searching for a receiver. The pass falls incomplete.
Second down.
It's now second down, 10 yards to go. The ball is on their own 20. The Tasmanian Devil, Troy Polamalu, was there to bring him down. Third down, 7 yards to go. Ball on their own 23. Passes short right side. Troy Polamalu was there for the stop.
Buccaneers were flying to the ball on that series. There's no way they were going to let them get a first down.
Number 85 will start his return to the 24.
That was really a good effort. There wasn't a ton of room for him to run, but he was able to get up the field, get a few yards. You never get upset with a punt return guy like that. It wasn't spectacular, but he got the job done.
The offense will take over at the 29-yard line. First down, 10 to go. A.J. Hawk was there to bring him down. That'll make it second down with 10 to go. Ball on their own 29. Hillis takes a handoff. And he's tackled right around the 32-yard line by Pickett. And third down now. They'll need 7 to convert. Good game.
So far, as we head into the fourth, our score here is the Buccaneers. They begin the fourth quarter with the ball, and they're up by a field goal.
dumps it short. That incomplete pass will bring up fourth down.
And it really looked like the defense won the battle up front. The big guys controlling the line of scrimmage made the difference there.
Returns the punt from the 16.
Well, here we are, the game on the line. The chance for this quarterback to lead his team down the field and win it.
And we know this guy is clutch. The defense knows this guy is clutch, and that is what it's all about.
They'll take over at the 21. And we'll have a first down and 10. The pocket collapsing.
As a quarterback, you understand where your protection is and what you can protect. If you can't protect a certain side, you have to throw it hot. That time the quarterback missed a hot read and paid the price.
He gets the sack and the offensive lineman didn't have much of a chance.
He delivered a perfect swim move and he was into the backfield in a flash. That's a kind of his signature move, if you will. And he's had a lot of success using it to get to the quarterback.
And it didn't look like the quarterback even saw him coming.
Yeah, he gets back there so fast that even if you have quick reaction time, you're still going to get sacked.
It's always kind of funny to think about with all the big guys that play the game of football. Sometimes it's the little wide receivers that scare you the most.
And the tackle was made by the beast, Brian Urlacher. Searching for an open man. Has it on the sideline, but was he inbound? The officials will huddle. They rule it incomplete. It's third down now, and just about the length of the football away from the first down marker. They'll throw for the first. Passes it deep on the left side. The defender gets a hand on it, and that will bring up fourth down.
I don't know if that's the guy I want to pick on third down when you have to have a conversion. He is tough.
Opts for a short throw. The stop was made by Brian Urlacher.
5-yard gain on the play.
Short throw to the right. Makes the grab near the sideline, but no signal yet. It's now second and 5. They spot it on the 39. Up the middle. They'll hurry back to the line. Throws to his right. He can't come up with it. Incomplete pass. And the pass will fall incomplete. Fourth down coming up.
Just terrific play by the defense. They followed the quarterback's eyes, made a quick jump on the ball, and were all over that one.
The kick is no good. He had an opportunity there. He just couldn't get it to go.
Oh, boy. This game has been so good throughout. It comes down to the field goal kicker, and he just can't get it done. I'm sure he's absolutely sick, and we've seen really weird things happen in football, but this is almost impossible now.
Nick Collins was there for the stop.
Pretty impressive stuff. As a back, you have to just keep slamming it in there, believing that hole's going to be there eventually. That time it was, and he took advantage.
The Packers will take their last time out. The offense sets up 7 yards away from the score. It's the tailback, and the tackle was made by B.J. Raji.
Tampa Bay calls timeout.
Tampa Bay looking to go up by two scores. Hillis on the run. They can't bring him down, and he's in. Here we are in the fourth quarter, and we finally get the game's first touchdown. It looks like they will go for two. Brady tosses it right. He's able to run it in for the two-point conversion. Great job there. They were able to get it in for two.
And you could tell the offense had a plan throughout that drive. Not only did they get the touchdown, but they immediately got the call in for the two-point conversion. They knew exactly what they wanted to do and executed it perfectly.
They'll try a squib kick. He's wrestled down right around the 40-yard line by Chung.
Chung 2 and T, bang.
That's it from Lambeau Field. Stay right there for our post-game highlight package. And let's take a look at the Gatorade Performer of the Game.
Of this telecast or of any pictures, descriptions, or accounts of the game without the NFL's consent is prohibited.